My name's Buzz, and this is my Phantomoth. See how beautiful they are? And we work cheap. Dirt cheap. In fact, I'm doing this interview for a cappuccino. And the half-baked promise that I might get fed later. We're here in Germany in this wonderful bar. How do you say bar in Germany?
Wunderbar.
Bar. Das Hundbar is Das Wunderbar. And we're over here on a promotional tour. On what? On Viva TV.
On Viva TV.
Viva TV. Viva 2. It was the station that's so big they had to have two. You guys want to bash on Faith No More for a while?
I only saw you once.
You only saw us once? Tell us what the worst part of the show was.
I only saw the very beginning of the show, and it was when we were doing aerobics, and actually I was impressed with it.
We used to come out and do aerobics on stage. What about you, Trevor? You can talk a little shit.
I remember one thing about a Faith No More show. A friend of mine was at the show, did a stage dive, and landed on the ground, and some people landed on top of him, and he shit his pants.
Yeah, I remember that. That was pretty good. And I don't think it was only shit that came out of that hole, if you know what I'm saying. What about you, Dave?
I remember seeing you guys at, what's that, Day on the Green, I think opening up for Metallica. And you had this mask on, this leather mask, with...
That wasn't me, that was Slipknot.
No, that was you. Slipknot copied you.
Oh, really? Because all the kids have been telling me that I've been ripping them off. I don't know what to say to him. I get a little embarrassed. My face turns red.
And you had this plug, like, you know, from a, what do you call it, the wash basin or whatever, you know, a sink. And it was like in his mouth. So he would pull it out and he would sing, and then put it back in, you know. And take it out and put it in sink. Okay. It was interesting. That fascinated me. Yeah. That's all.
So Dave has been attracted to me ever since. What can I say? I think I can probably sum it up in one sentence. Our drummer plays in Korn now! Nuff said!
Say that collectively, do you think Slayer weighs more than Phantomas? Do you think they're a fatter band? Is in terms of heavier, do you think they're fatter, like with a PH?
Oh yeah, absolutely. At least 200 kilograms a piece fatter. Yeah, and kilogram.
Dave, what do you think about Kerry King expressing his disapproval for Phantomas?
Oh, Kerry King. You know, Kerry King. I spoke to him, let's see, don't even get me started on Kerry King. Okay?
This is going to take
a while. Okay, this is going to take a while. Here. Eine Coffee bitte. Okay. I have not seen Kerry King in over 8 years, right? 8 years.
It's getting cold.
And the only thing he tells me is Lars Ulrich looks like Ross Halfin, which is a photographer. And I said, really? Yes, we all have similarities in this big world, you know? The guy only had that one little sentence to say to me in over 8 years. The guy has a size, his brain is the size of a hasselnusse? In the kokonusse, he has a hasselnusse. Yeah, well, I really don't care. We are heavier, as in heavy, and they are fatter, as in fat. So that's all I have to say.
Ah, that was good, Dave.
Anna Klein. Anna Klein of coffee. And that was it. It was weird. It was a strange experience being in a band like that. It was like somebody put on a space suit and said, "You're going to be in a metal band," and that was it. And now I'm in Phantomas.
And then you woke up.
Yeah. And I smelled the flowers and I left. Hello. Guten Tag. How's everything going? This is Phantomus. And we're here to rock the house.
Rock the house.
You know? Lift the roof. What is that?
Rock the Doss house. Raisin Doss roof.
Yeah.
Raisin
Doss
roof.
Having a coffee? And not watching Viva.
Ah!
Mr. Pat and I went to school together. Junior high, high school, college, all that shit. And we were in a band together in like the ninth grade. Wow. The age of like 15 or something.
We would play cover songs of his fat band.
Yeah, in fact, we did. We played in a band that did Aggressive Perfector off the very first Slayer record.
Which was a Metallica ripoff.
It was a Metallica ripoff. The intro is exactly like Hit the Lights. The middle part is exactly like Hit the Lights. And everything else.
What else is there?
Listen to him side by side.
Dave's a little critical of his band, yeah.
We also did Metallica covers in that band, too.
Mm-hmm. Hit the Light.
Yeah, in fact.
A bunch of different versions of Hit the Light.
Ha 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 ha
Well, here's the problem that we're having with this upcoming Mr. Bungle Tour. We don't have an opening band yet. So if any of you dirtbags out there have a band and you'd like to open for us, what's your phone number? I mean, your personal phone number.
Actually, you can send us cassettes, but make sure they're a Maxell 90 minutes and leave the tabs in.
Okay, here's the only condition. It has to be no more than two people in the band, and you have to play naked.
You'll get takers.
That's it. No, two people in the band, no more than two. One's okay, one or two. You have to play naked.
How about two people and a puppet?
A puppet would be wonderful.
Yeah. Like I said!
About the label? Sure. What do you want to know about the label? Let's see. It's called Ipecac. I started it with a friend. Ipecac is a root that they make syrup out of that you can buy in the pharmacy. Apotec. Yeah. And it makes you kotzen. It's for little babies when they swallow poison. So they can, you know, they don't die. They make kotzen, yeah? And that's what our label does when people put on the records. We make you kotzen.
I'm gonna be good to you.
Think. We put out about 10 or so records so far in our first year, and they're all threatening the Chili Peppers' sales. We're hot on their heels, 50 million worldwide. Put out Melvin's records, Phantomus records, what else? Kid 606, Kids of Woodney High, Maldoror, ooh, the country band Lucky Stars, and a record of Prank Phone Calls, an absolute classic called Great Phone Calls. They're imported now. They're being released here in October, November. We have a distribution deal, and I think it'll go through AFA here in Germany, so should be easy to find and cheaper.
Maybe there'll be more.
maybe they'll be easier to find and twice as expensive. Yeah. I think it's about time I bartend. What do you say? What would you guys like?
How about a mojito?
You want a mojito?
I gotta use a toilet.
Maybe we'll ask her. You might have to ask her, though, because she doesn't like us.
I'll be right back.
No, I think she's tolerating.
You think? We've been sitting over here saying terrible words in German.
Have we?
Oh, yeah.
But we don't speak the language. Obviously.
Therefore. What would you like, Buzz, to drink?
Oh, drinking. I just had two cappuccinos. I think I'm doing all right, actually. Pretty jazzed up. It's good. Coffee is the fuel that will keep you alive.
I might have one more.
teeth were gone, so I take your face with the teeth.
When we come back to Germany, I got to rethink this whole thing, because I'm sick of this Bavarian, this whole Bavarian end of the country, you know, and I think we might just skip it. I totally skip it. Now, the Melvins have a lot of records that just recently came out, and we're going to come back over here and pretty much stomp your measly little tiny country. It's as small as Wyoming. You guys have less people than we have in California. Let's go to war with the U.S. again. Let's see who wins this time. Let's go. Come on. Come on, I challenge you. I challenge you.
Buzz challenges Buzz the country of Germany.
I challenge Germany to take on the U.S. again. The problem with Germany is you guys can't fight a war. You don't know what you're doing. You can stir up shit, but you can't finish it. I'm sick and tired of it. You wimps. You measly little wimps. Driving around in your Volkswagens and your Mercedes. Every time I see a Mercedes in LA, I want to ram it. Anyway, that's enough Melvin's talk.
Chickens in hell, in blonde witchery. Chop a chip. Just a dog, dog and share. See you next time. Ciao.